Hi students, I welcome everyone for 10th standard social science civics unit 3 the state government. In this lesson we are going to learn about the structure of the state government, powers and functions of the governor, chief minister and council of ministers, and functioning of the judicial system in the state. Let me enter into the video session. Civics unit 3 the state government.
Introduction. India is a huge country. The Constitution of India envisages for a federal government having a separate system of administration for the union and the states. The Constitution means fundamental law of the state. Envisages means as a possibility. And federal government, federal means relating to a system of government in which several states form a unity but remain independent in internal affairs. There are 28 states and 9 union territories. The Constitution contains provision for the governance of both the union and the states. It lays down a uniform structure for the state government in Part 6 of the Constitution from Article 152 to 237, which is applicable to all the states. Only the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which has a separate constitution for its government under Article 370. The structure of the state government, as formed in the center, consists of three branches. These are the executive, the legislature and the judiciary. State government consists of three branches, that is executive, legislature and judiciary. Executive means having the power to plan. Under executive, governor, chief minister and council of ministers. Legislature means passing a law. Under legislature, legislative council, that is upper house, and legislative assembly, that is lower house. And judiciary, judiciary means relating to the administration of justice. Under judiciary, high courts, district courts and other courts. The state executive consists of governor, chief minister and council of ministers. The governor is the constitutional head of the state executive. Our state is Tamil Nadu. The governor. Who is our governor? Mr. Banwarilal Purohit. The administration of a state is carried on in the name of the governor. Generally, there is a separate governor in each state. But if the situation warrants so, the same person may be appointed as the governor of two or more states. The governor of a state shall be appointed by the president. His usual term of office is 5 years, but he holds office during the pleasure of the president. Generally, the governor does not belong to the state where he is appointed. He can also be transferred from one state to another by the president. He can also resign any time by addressing his resignation to the president. Qualification of a governor. He should be a citizen of India. He must have completed 35 years of age. He should not be a member of parliament or any state legislature. If he is a member of any of legislature, he automatically vacates his seat on assuming the office. He should not hold any other profitable occupation.
The powers and functions of the governor. The governor is the head of the state executive and he has enormous power. As the executive head in the state level, the governor has the following functions and powers. First one is executive powers, legislative powers, financial powers, judicial powers, discretionary powers and emergency powers. The executive powers and functions of the governor are: he appoints the leader of the majority party in the state legislative assembly as the chief minister of the state. He appoints other members of the council of ministers on the recommendation of the chief minister. He appoints the chairman and members of the State Public Service Commission. However, they can be removed only by the president and not by a governor. He acts as the chancellor of universities in the state. He also appoints the vice chancellor of universities in the state. He directly rules the state when there is the imposition of the president's rule in the state. Legislative powers. The governor is an integral part of the state legislature. He has the right to summon, prorogue the state legislature and dissolve the state legislative assembly. Summon means order, prorogue means discontinue. And he can address the state legislature after each general election. And he can send messages to the houses of the state legislature relating to a bill pending in the legislature. He can appoint any member of the legislative assembly. And he can nominate one member to the state legislature assembly from the Anglo-Indian community. And every bill passed by the state legislature will become a law only after his signature. But when a bill is sent to the governor after it is passed by the legislature, he has the option to give his assent to the bill or withhold his assent to the bill or return the bill for the consideration of the legislature. and he can promulgate and withdraw an ordinance at any time, and he has to lay the annual reports of the State Finance Commission, the State Public Service Commission, and the Controller and Auditor General relating to the accounts of the state. Financial powers. The Constitution confers on the Governor the duty to get prepared and introduce to the state legislature the annual budget and also the supplementary budgets if necessary. Money bills can be introduced in the state legislature only with this the prior recommendation, and he constitute a finance commission after every 5 years to review the financial position of the panchayats and the municipalities.
Judicial powers. He appoints the attorney general of the state. He appoints judges to the subordinate courts in the state. He makes appointment, postings and promotion of the district judges in the consultation with the state High Court. And the Chief Justice of the High Court in the state is appointed by the President in consultation with him. And he can pardon, commute or reprieve punishment on receipt of appeals for mercy. Discretionary powers. The Governor can reserve a bill for the consideration of the President. And he can call the leader of any party to form ministry in the state. And he can dismiss the Council of Ministers when it is unable to prove the confidence of the Legislative Assembly. Emergency powers. If the Governor is satisfied that the government of the state is not carried on in accordance with the provision of the Constitution, he may under Article 356 recommend to the President to impose President rule in that state. As soon as the President rule is imposed, the administration of the state is carried on by the Governor as the representative of the President. Privileges of the Governor. The Governor of a state is not be answerable to any court for the exercise and performance of the powers and duties of his office or any act to be done by him in the exercise and performance of those powers and duties. No process for the arrest or imprisonment of the Governor of a state shall issue from any court during his term of office. Chief Minister. Who is our Chief Minister? Mr. Edappadi K. Palaniswamy. The Governor is the nominal executive authority and the Chief Minister is the real executive authority. In other words, the Governor is the head of the state while the Chief Minister is the head of the government. The appointment of the Chief Minister. The Chief Minister is appointed by the Governor of the state. The term of the Chief Minister is not fixed. He may remain as the Chief Minister as long as he enjoys the support of the majority of the members of the Legislative Assembly. He has to resign when he loses confidence of the majority in the assembly. It is understood that normally he completes 5 years terms like other members in the Legislative Assembly. Powers and functions of the Chief Minister. The Chief Minister is the real executive head of the state administration. So he has the following powers and functions. Powers relating to the Council of Ministers, relating to the Governor, relating to the state legislature. Relating to the Council of Ministers. The Chief Minister recommends the persons who can be appointed as ministers by Governor, and he allocates the portfolios among the ministers, and he shuffles and reshuffles his ministry. He presides over the meeting of the Council of Ministers and influences its decisions. He guides, directs, controls and coordinates the activities of all the ministers. Relating to the Governor. The Chief Minister is the principal channel of communication between the Governor and the Council of Ministers. So, Chief Minister advises the Governor in relation to the appointment of the following officials. Advocate General of the State, State Election Commissioner, Chairman and Members of the State Public Service Commission, Chairman and Members of the State Planning Commission, Chairman and Members of the State Finance Commission. Relating to State Legislature, Chief Minister announces the government policies on the floor of the House and he can introduce the bills in the Legislative Assembly. He can recommend for the dissolution of the Legislative Assembly to the Governor at any time. Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers shall be appointed by the Governor on the advice of the Chief Minister. The Council of Ministers are collectively responsible to the State Legislature. All the members of the Council of Ministers must be the members of the State Legislature. All the ministers work as a team under the Chief Minister. As long as the Chief Minister is in office, the Council of Ministers will also be in power. If no confidence motion is passed by the Legislative Assembly, the State Minister shall resign. The functions and powers of the Council of Ministers. It formulates and decides the policy of the state and implements them effectively. It decides the legislative programs of the Legislative Assembly and sponsors all important bills. It controls the financial policy and decide the tax structure for the public welfare of the state. It makes the important appointment of the head of department. It discusses and take efforts on the dispute with other states. It frames the proposal for incurring expenditure out of state reserves. It decides all the bills, whether ordinary bills or money bills, to be introduced in the legislative assembly. Each minister of the Council of Ministers supervises, controls and coordinates the department concerned. Annual financial statement called as the budget is finalized by the Council of Ministers. The state legislature. The constitution provides the legislature for every state. Most of the states have only unicameral legislature, that is legislative assembly. Some states has bicameral legislature, that is legislative assembly and legislative council. Example, Bihar, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir. The legislative assembly, lower house, that is Lok Sabha. The legislative assembly is a popular house. It is the real center of power in the state. It consists of members directly elected by the people on the basis of adult franchise. Adult franchise means a person after 18 years of age or eligible to put a vote. The strength of the assembly varies from state to state depending on the population. However, the maximum strength of the assembly must not exceed 500 or its minimum strength not be below 60. The term of office of the legislative assembly is 5 years. It can be dissolved even before the expiry of its terms. Cabinet committees. A smaller body called cabinet is the nucleus of the Council of Ministers. It consists of only the cabinet ministers. It is the real center of authority in the state government. The cabinet works through various committees called cabinet committees. They are of two types, standing and ad hoc. The former and are of a permanent nature, while the latter are of temporary nature. The Speaker. The Legislative Assembly elects two of its members as the Speaker and Deputy Speaker. The Speaker vacates his office if he cannot continue to be a member of the Assembly. He may also resign his office at any time. The Speaker may be removed from office by a resolution of the Assembly after giving a 14 days notice. Such a resolution must be passed by a majority of the members present at the time of voting. The Speaker does not vacate his office when the assembly is dissolved. He continues to be the speaker until the first sitting of the new assembly. While the office of the speaker is vacate, the deputy speaker performs his functions. The Legislative Council, Upper House, that is Rajya Sabha. The Legislative Council is the upper house of the state legislature. It is constituted as a permanent house. The Vidhan Parishad, that is Legislative Council, forms a part of the state legislature of India. And every member of Legislative Council serves for a 6-year term and 1/3 of members expire every 2 years. Members of Legislative Councils must be a citizen of India not under 30 years of age. And he or she should be mentally sound and not bankrupt, and his name should be in the voters list of the state from which he or she is contesting the election. The Chairman. The Chairman is the presiding officer of the Upper House. The members elect a chairman and a deputy chairman from among themselves. In the absence of the chairman, the deputy chairman officiate the functions of the Legislative Council. Abolition or creation of Legislative Councils. Article 169 deals with the creation or abolition of Legislative Council in a state. If the state legislative assembly passes a resolution by a majority and requesting the parliament to create or abolish the state legislative council, then the parliament may by law provide for the abolition and creation of the legislative council. Functions of the state legislature. The powers and functions of the state legislature are almost the same as that of a parliament. Legislative powers, financial powers, controls over the executive. Legislative powers. The state legislature can pass laws on all subjects mentioned in the state list as per the constitution. It can also pass laws on concurrent subjects. The state-made law in a concurrent subject will become inoperative when the center also passes a law on the same subject. And every bill passes through 3 readings. Then it becomes an act with the governor's assent. Financial powers. The legislature controls the finances of the state. The lower house enjoys greater power than the upper house in money matters. Money bills can be introduced only in the lower house or the assembly. No new tax can be levied without the sanction and permission of the assembly. Controls over the executive. The legislature controls the executive. The council of ministers is responsible to the assembly. The ministers have to answer questions asked by the members of the legislature, and they can be removed from office if the assembly passes a vote of no confidence motion against the ministry. Judiciary of state, high courts. The institution of high court originated in India in 1862 when the high courts were set up at Calcutta, Bombay and Madras. In the course of time, each province in British India came to have its own high court. After 1950, a high court existing in a province became the high court for the corresponding state. The high court or the highest court at state level. The Constitution of India provides for a high court for each state, but the 7th Amendment Act of 1956 authorized the parliament to establish a common high court for two or more states or for two or more states and a union territory. Every high court has a chief justice and a number of judges. The number of judges varies from state to state. The number of judges of each high court is determined by the president. At present, there are 25 high courts for 28 states and 9 union territories. Jurisdiction and powers of high court. Jurisdiction means the authority of a court to rule on certain cases are called jurisdiction. At present, a high court enjoys the following jurisdiction and powers. First one is original jurisdiction, appellate jurisdiction, writ jurisdiction, supervisory jurisdiction and court of record. Original jurisdiction. It means the power to handle those cases which cannot be moved in any court other than high courts. The presidency high courts have original jurisdiction in which the amount involved is more than 2000 and in criminal cases which are committed to them by the presidency magistrates. Appellate jurisdiction. Appellate means the power to handle the cases on appeal against the judgment delivered by any district court or subordinate court in the country. All high courts entertain appeals in civil and criminal cases from their subordinate courts. Important cases with or without district court certificate can appeal. Writ jurisdiction. Under Article 226 of the Constitution, the high courts are given powers of issuing writs not only for the enforcement of the fundamental rights but also for other purposes. An order from a judicial authority asking a person to perform or not to perform an act. To issue directions, order or writs including writs in the nature of habeas corpus, that is to have body, mandamus, be ordered to perform a duty, writ of prohibition, that is be ordered to stop a duty and writ of certiorari to be performed of what is going on and quo warranto, by what order. It's all important writs. Supervisory jurisdiction. High Court has the power of superintendence over all courts and tribunals functioning in its territorial jurisdictions. Thus, it may be call for writs from them, make an issue, general rules and prescribe forms for regulating the practice and proceeding of them, and prescribe forms in which books, entries and accounts are to be kept by them, and settle the fees payable to the sheriff, clerks, officer and legal officer of them. Court of record. All the decisions issued by the High Court are printed and are kept as a record for future references as well as by the lawyers if such a need arises. Thus, it also acts as a court of record. Let we go through a short recap. The governor is the constitutional head of the state executive. The chief minister is appointed by the governor of the state. The council of ministers are collectively responsible to the state legislature. The Legislative Assembly is the real center of power in the state. At present, there are 25 high courts for 28 states and 9 union territories. Dear students, go through the lesson and learn book back exercise. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.